manufacturing company Rockwell.
That's right. WDVM's Aaliyah Williamson has been following this story and joins us now live in the studio with the very latest. Good evening.
Good evening, Fred and Vesmeen. Thank you for that. I have been following the back and forth between manufacturing company Rockwell and many Jefferson County residents for years. And every time there seems to be a new component of concern from some. This latest one was hidden for years, but now some are hoping to bring awareness. Take a look.
At first glance, it looks like an empty field, but at least 80 people are buried here.
A lot of them worked at the orchard, at the quarry, like locally. They lived right here.
Mm-hmm.
They went to the local churches.
And all of them African Americans, part of the Hartstown community.
And they just were like a very tight-knit community.
My dad's best friend was buried over there.
Oh.
Yeah, and so I know these people.
This is the Boyd Carter Cemetery. For years, it was taken care of by the families of the buried. But recently, people like Jennifer King and Addison Reese discovered the hidden history.
Being involved with the Rockwell opposition, I saw the site plans, and I knew that this cemetery was probably going to be in danger.
These markers indicate where the fracked gas pipeline will stand.
These stakes and the middle of the road we're standing next to. So that puts it roughly right about where I'm standing.
The West Virginia DEP quietly told legislators that they had approved the next step for the pipeline before a public hearing was held.
The permit was already approved back on Friday by Austin Caperton.
Where did you get that information from?
From our delegate, John Doyle.
Raising new concerns.
Heavy traffic through this area could affect the cemetery. So even a big truck just turning around accidentally
could.
There's all kinds of things.
Knock into a headstone or go over a grave.
So now these people are left to fight for those who have already passed on.
Well, we've got two construction projects happening. We got Rockwell and the gas pipeline. And we just want to ensure that they do not encroach on the cemetery.
Now, Addison and Jennifer both emphasized to me that their focus and the focus of those who own the cemetery is to protect the land from any danger, not just Rockwell or the pipeline, although those seem to be the current threats to them now. I reached out to Rockwell. They said that the issue of the sewer line is between the West Virginia DEP and Mountaineer Gas, so they declined to comment. Reporting in the studio, I'm Aaliyah Williamson. Back to you.
Thank you, Aaliyah, for that report. Now, for more information on the Boyd Carter Cemetery, visit our website at localdvm.com for a link to more details.
Mineral County and West Virginia.